Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on the introduction and functionality of the 750 case control.
Thanks, Keith. The AK-CC 750 is our multi-evap case controller from our AdaptCool product line. The 750 can handle anywhere between 1 to 4 evaporators on a single case, with each evaporator being controlled either by a liquid line solenoid valve based on case temperature, or an electronic expansion valve, which will be based off of case temperature and superheat. The electronic expansion valve needs to be our pulsing type of valve, such as an AKV. We would not be controlling a stepper valve in that application. The 750 is a full case controller, so you'll see additional control options for defrost heaters, anti-sweat heaters, case fans, and case lights. And you'll also see that you can apply the case controller to multiple types of case designs, so options for dual temp cases, walk-ins, and with defrost termination, options for time, temperature, or digital termination there. Out of the box, the 750 comes with 11 inputs and 8 outputs. Our 11 inputs would be for our temp sensors in the case, pressure transducer, and any dry contact digital points that we're controlling, such as a dual temp switch. And then our 8 relays would be for our expansion valves or liquid line solenoid valves. And then an additional 4 relays for the secondary case functions that we just mentioned. Now, the 11 inputs and 8 outputs may not be sufficient when you start to get into the larger applications with 3 and 4 evaporators being controlled. In that scenario, what we'll do is take one of our standard AK2 modules. It can be attached directly to the end of the main 750 baseboard. And then the additional control points on that extension module become part of the setup of the main 750 itself. Programming of the 750 takes place one of two ways. Either through our service tool software, which would be loaded onto a computer and directly connected into the Cat5 port on the front of the controller. Alternatively, if you have a setup where the 750 is tied into a system manager, such as our AKSM 850 or 880, the setup in the 850 or 880 can be downloaded into the case controller, where we define all of our parameters there. And then once the unit's been brought online, we send them down to the case controller. Nice feature as far as the setup of the inputs and outputs is our quick setup. So here we're not going to have to assign each input and output individually. Here we can use a single selection from a drop-down menu, again called a quick setup, and that's going to automatically define the function of all of our inputs and outputs on the case controller. Makes for a quick setup, and as long as we've identified that the case controller needs to be wired to match that quick setup that's being used, it'll become a huge time saver. Two energy savings features that the 750 offers that are worth pointing out. One is our adaptive defrost. So here we'll look at the regularly scheduled defrost that the case manufacturer has recommended. And for each one of those scheduled times, we'll look to see if we can skip the defrost if there's no ice buildup on the coil. Prevents us from adding unnecessary load onto the case and overall system performance. Secondly is our adaptive superheat control. Here we'll look to minimize our superheat within a user-defined range as much as possible. This will optimize performance of the evaporator and, again, the overall system performance. Lastly, I'll point out that the 750 comes in two different variations as far as part number. This will boil down to the system manager's communication type that you're using, which is either going to be RS-485 echelon or TP-78 echelon communication. Each one of those two types has its own part number for the 750 to tie into the system manager appropriately. All the other functionality of the controller would remain the same between the two part numbers. Just something to pay attention to. And that is our AK-CC 750 case controller.
For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.